A fundamental element of an RPG is the ability to talk to an NPC, oftentimes to make decisions that will impact the game world, making it feel like your actions had an effect, when they didn't and nothing you do will ever matter. But what if you wanted to be the quiet kid who sits in the front of the bus asking the teachers about what they think of his nose gold? Can you beat Fallout 3 without talking to anyone? The simple answer is no, obviously you can't, but there are steps you can take to limit the number of people you have to interact with. As for what counts as talking to anyone, anything that involves the dialogue menu. If you see the option to tell them goodbye, you've already failed. Naturally, that comes with its own set of challenges. The beginning of the game is dead simple. I've done this multiple times by now. It's just that this time I'm abandoning my father instead of him abandoning me. Now I could have, within the limitations of this challenge, assigned my special points before I began my grand escape. You don't speak to your father during this part of the game. You can make baby noises at him, but you don't have to. You can walk up to him, say nothing, he'll leave you alone with an assortment of different choking hazards, and you can assign your special points, but it's unnecessary. To begin escaping the vault as a baby, you abuse the game's instantaneous quicksave quickload mechanic to glitch yourself through a wall, at which point you'll fall through the eternity of gray nothing and be placed at a part of the vault you can only be in if your current objective is to escape the vault. It was harder than usual to transcend reality and make the wall my I couldn't tell you why. Going back to special stats for a moment, I didn't bother assigning them, because the only enemies you'll find in the vault at this point, because things are a little weird, is a handful of rad roaches. As usual, I was completely defenseless against them. Babies naturally suck at hand-to-hand combat and lack the fine motor skills required to hold a gun, so you can't go on the offensive to take the fight to the bugs that probably weigh more than both your legs combined. Then you just snag the Overseer's key, open the tunnel, waddle to the vault door, and you're given the option to make any last-minute modifications to your character before entering the real meat of Fallout 3. I wasn't sure which way I wanted to go with any of my stats, so I just drained charisma and evenly distributed the remaining points to have both a well-rounded character and to have a solid assortment of perks to pick from upon leveling up. Out into the capital wasteland, things went downhill quickly. The only challenge that broke my heart this early on was the Fallout 3 without moving the camera video. If you've seen a couple of my other Fallout 3 videos, such as the one I just mentioned, you probably have an idea of what the problem is here. See, by escaping the vault as a baby, you're never given the Pip-Boy by the Overseer at your 10th birthday, because you're still too stupid to be a 10-year-old. Normally, it's a momentary annoyance that is solved by talking to Lucas Sims in Megaton, but I can't talk to Lucas Sims. I can't talk to anyone, which means the problem can never be solved. You're probably wondering what the other casualties are from this inability to obtain a Pip-Boy. They are many, and they are disastrous. Obviously, without a Pip-Boy, you can't equip any weapons of any kind. You can't equip any armor either. You also can't use any healing items or look at the map, set any waypoints, fast travel to any location, or even listen to the radio. Now remember that I'm also still a baby. I can't outrun a mole rat, or a vicious dog, or a rat scorpion, or anything that has a pair of functioning legs. But it gets worse. Good God, I wish those were the only things I couldn't do. 372 words ago, I told you that I was defenseless while in the vault. Because nothing has changed since then, I'm also defenseless outside of the vault. Not only can I not equip any weapons, I can't smack people with my barely developed hands. I have absolutely no way of attacking anything. You know what else I can't do? I can't sneak. The medical explanation, if my 0 seconds of research and completely baseless assumption is to be believed, has to do with a baby's legs not having kneecaps yet. Most people don't get kneecaps until they hit puberty. So let's recap what I can do in Fallout 3 at the moment. I can walk around, I can jump, and that's about it. Going into it, I knew it was gonna be a complete show, but I had a plan. I was gonna wing it. Metaphorically shoot from the hip, and just see what juices I can squeeze from the lifeless corpse of a game. The first and primary concern was getting to Little Lamplight. Going down the main quest line isn't an option. You'll hit a roadblock eventually, specifically during your 10th birthday where you have to shoot the rad roach. You can't do that without talking to Dad, as you don't get the BB gun unless you talk to him. I ran into the first real problem, in the form of an escaped slave, who for some reason ran up to a baby and asked it to help get her collar off. I wasn't sure if this counted as talking to someone or not. She runs up to you, says something, you make a decision, then she explodes. You don't have to say anything, but the NPC talking text box pops up nonetheless. I trusted my gut after getting covered in hers, and reloaded a save to take a slightly different path to Little Lamplight. I don't need to say too much about how annoying it is to once again travel from Vault 101 to Little Lamplight as a baby. It sucks and takes a long time. I may have even attempted baby's first suicide by jumping off a cliff. That was a doozy of a sentence, wasn't it? The next obstacle in my path came in the form of mutated creatures harassing me just outside of Smith Casey's garage. A bloatfly and a mole rat, to be specific. I sought refuge inside the garage, hoping to wait for a while until the unpleasantness outside subsided. Couldn't wait inside because of the roaches and mole rats in the next room that I had no means of destroying. There are children outside, yelling, being annoying. They're gonna f***ing die. In theory, I could let them tear chunks of flesh off my body as I ran helplessly into the loving arms of a rusty barrel that, with all that action, may start flying around and cause damage to them. It's happened before, but with no way to heal myself, that wasn't a risk I was going to take. I tried one time to outrun the creatures outside waiting for me on the other side of the door, before realizing how futile that effort was. Something exploded, and I saw what I really looked like. It was, well, that's a baby, alright. I went back to the bridge of shattered legs, and again took a new path towards Little Lamplight, completely ignoring Smith Casey's garage. I remember slamming on the brakes while I looked at Goo Lagoon. I was gonna use this moment to talk about something in the video, but my mind can't recall what that something was going to be. Maybe it was gonna be about the summer sausage I left in my mailbox for a month to fry in the sun of Michigan's midday sun, before freezing solid again when darkness reclaimed the state. In time, as I always do, I made it to Little Lamplight. I also paused the challenge to see if there are any hidden surprises in this treehouse. There isn't. Inside Lamplight, I used the tried and true quick save trick to get through a wall near the entrance to avoid having to speak to the world's most densely packed ego. From there, I attempted to clip through the wall at the usual spot. Getting into the correct position is difficult when you're small and can barely jump an inch off the ground. After failing at that spot, I entered the Great Chamber, clipped through the wall, and blew my own mind. I was inside Vault 87. I had no idea this was possible. I'd wasted so much time in other runs by not doing this. For the briefest of moments, there was actual enthusiasm in my voice. It didn't last long. This isn't Vault 87. It's an entrance to Vault 87 in the back of Little Lamplight. If you had a high enough science skill, you could hack the door and get inside. And, theoretically, I could have done that. Intelligence of 10 and luck of 10 will put your starting science skill at 27. Add 15 points by picking science as a tag skill, and 17 more points by leveling up after you exit Vault 101, and your science skill is at 59. An average terminal only requires 50 science to open. Perhaps that will come into play in a later challenge. Not that I even plan on playing Fallout 3 again after this. This game died a year ago, and all I've been doing since then is desecrating the corpse. After I spent 15 years walking back from the Great Chamber to the Gate of Murder Pass, I clipped through the side of the gate, entered Murder Pass, and let the suffering begin. I've done this before and it's never fun. You're so slow that every mutant you pass will be able to keep up with you and attack you constantly. The only thing working to your advantage is that because of your size, their attacks miss more frequently than they normally would. By the time I got to the reactor chamber, my health was nearly gone, and with no way to heal myself, I was out of ideas. The reactor chamber is home to more mutants with better weaponry than those in Murder Pass. I had no hope of sneaking past them, and that was where I left the challenge for a while, in a stalemate between man and machine. In the time between the second and third recording for this video, I played through Diablo 3. That video will be out either before or after this one, because that's how time works. And came up with no ideas for how to proceed. That's sort of a lie. I had an idea, it just wasn't a good one. This run experienced a seismic ideological shift in what the core concept of this challenge really is. In the beginning, it was a video about whether or not I can do this. I can't. Without the ability to heal, I could not get through Murder Pass with enough health to reach the Gek. So this video became an is it possible type video. If in some magical hypothetical scenario, you could contend with the super mutants. How much else of the game could you beat without talking to anyone? Where do the other problems lie? This is where the real video ends and the begins. I enable God mode, to get to the get portion of the reactor chamber. I also released Fox as an easy way to kill some of the mutants in the area without explicitly cheating, which in retrospect was a stupid thing to do, considering what I did moments before that and what was coming. Once in the Garden of Eden Creation Kit dormitory, I paused all enemy AI to give myself the illusion of getting there with them dead, and attempted to retrieve the Gek without God mode enabled. I wasn't sure how much health I should have had. I used a command to check my current health, held my keyboard up to the screen, counted the number of keys my current health spanned, did a series of complex mathematical calculations to determine that my health should have been at around 200, set it to 200, and crawled to the Gek. That was also a complete waste of time, because your health has no bearing on how much radiation damage you can take. My speed caused me to hit deadly radiation poisoning by the time I was in the doorway, and I dropped dead before even touching the Gek. My next brilliant strategy was to use a dose of Radex. Giving myself the Pip-Boy didn't give me the ability to open my Pip-Boy and use any of the drugs that acquired. Bethesda went to great lengths to keep children from being able to overdose in their games. Whatever. This idea is all a fever dream anyway. God mode enabled, pick up the Gek, escape. Easy peasy when you're a dirty cheater with a big nose. The next theoretical roadblock was the Enclave. If you get captured, you're forced to dialogue with Colonel Autumn before you can move freely around their base. Clearly, that wasn't an option. I avoided the Enclave abduction by clipping through a wall, which placed me just outside Fox's cell. Before making my way back through Murder Pass, I used the Resurrection command to bring the failed FEV experiment back to life. Then I killed him with a different command and crashed the game. Turns out that forcing life onto something that was never meant to be alive, then stripping that life away, is a way to collapse the universe in on itself. I avoided talking to MacReady at the front gate by taking large steps to the left and avoiding his all-seeing gaze. You know what? None of this even matters anymore. I did a bunch of different shit but ended up at the Citadel because there was nowhere else to go. You can't trigger the endgame without escaping from the Enclave base. Giving the Gek to the Brotherhood of Steel wasn't an option, because it's not supposed to be able to happen. I have now thoroughly explored all possibilities for beating Fallout 3 without talking to anyone, and none of them work. But there is one last thing we can do, something with guaranteed success. Through some combination of dialogue choices, you can beat Fallout 3 by talking to as few people as possible and saying as few words as possible. I was voted as the quietest guy in my high school class. I was f***ing made for this. I was born again in a way I never saw coming, picked my special stats based around getting as many points into speech as possible, with the idea that passing speech checks would be the key to getting out of a conversation with as few words said by both parties as possible, and began my 10th birthday party. Normally, a modder will initiate dialogue as soon as you're given control of your character, but if you back away instantly, that won't happen. From there, you must talk to two people, the old woman and your father. After saying a total of two words to Old Lady Palmer, Butch will get up and try to bully you. If you're fancy with your movement, you can avoid him. This isn't easy. There are spots on the table that you can get stuck on, and you can't just run around both sets of tables, as a modder will tell you happy birthday if you get too close. There's a delicate dance that must be performed here, until such a time where Jonas Ring-a-Ding-Dingsters your father, at which point you'll have to talk to him to get the door to the hallway opened, but you won't actually say any words to him. Beatrice will try to give you a stupid poem that she wrote. You'll avoid her, say 8 words to Jonas, 10 words to Dad, break the targets, kill the bug, get your photo taken, time will fly by, and you'll wake up in front of your father on the day of the GOAT exam. You can say all sorts of things to him, ask him a couple questions, or you can just say 2 words. Snag the medicine bobblehead, and begin your great escape. For all intents and purposes, I followed the same path as you would in a Fallout 3 speedrun. At this point, the game considers you an adult, so you can clip through the wall, the escape quest will trigger, and you can leave the vault without saying another word. At the door, I chose small guns, speech, and medicine as my tag skills, dumped all points into speech after leveling up outside, looted the hollowed out rock near Megaton, and headed for Little Lamplight. Not long after leaving the vault, I killed a scavenger and got a serious upgrade to my arsenal of weapons. Then another upgrade, after I ended a handful of raiders with a missile launcher I'd gotten from the scavenger. I took out Doc Huff, his caravan guard, and the Pap Brahmin as well. Inside Little Lamplight, I did what Baby Me did back in the day to bypass MacReady, glitched myself through the gate at Murder Pass, and entered Vault 87 proper. I'd also assigned weapons, stim packs, and Rad X to every available hotkey, as the problem of not being able to use my Pip-Boy reared its head again. I freed Fox for the same reason I did last time, to take out some of the mutants attacking me, picked up the Gek, and got abducted by the Enclave. There was no way around that. A series of events must unfold in Ravenrock to place the game in a state where it's able to be beaten. I ran through various dialogue options with Autumn until I found a set of choices where I said the fewest number of words possible. 17. There are actually two paths to get this interaction over with in 17 words. Not that it matters. The only guy you might have trouble with is the Enclave officer, hiding outside your holding cell. He'll look the other way if you toss a live grenade his way. President Eden takes an unfortunate 49 words to end his dialogue. You're basically just saying you'll consider what he says and you'll be on your way. Convincing him to blow himself up is the preferred option from a gameplay perspective, but it's too costly from a dictionary standpoint. Escaping Ravenrock is combat, that you can do if you want. I just ignored everyone, left, fast traveled back to Vault 101, and headed for the Jefferson Memorial. The last time I came this way, I passed by an opportunity to end a certain someone. This time, from the safety of a rock, I fired a warning shot into Grandma Sparkles. She spasmed like crazy, and the game crashed. That f***ing is nothing if not predictable. There's nobody you're required to talk to on the road to the Jefferson Memorial. Inside, I clipped myself into the purifier and realized that I had to talk to Autumn again to set this up properly. Simply knocking out his skin isn't enough to do it. The quickest path to salvation is giving up on diplomacy by uttering the last 6 words of your life, activating Project Purity, and that's that. I could not beat Fallout 3 without talking to anyone, but I did beat it by saying only 94 words to other characters in the game. God, this video sucked. If you enjoyed the video or learned anything, which you didn't, leave a like. Leave a dislike if you didn't enjoy the video or didn't learn anything. Thanks to the Champion Tier supporters as well as other channel members for making videos like this one possible. Join the Mitten Squad Discord server through a link in the video description. Follow me on Twitter @MittenSquad. My name is Paula of Mitten Squad. Have a wonderful day.